So far, so good. Got a cup of coffee, had a nice drive here, saw a bunch of stuff, drove past Buckingham Palace. I've been here a few times, though. I love London. Any excuse to come back. Yeah. Yeah, it was great. Like, I had a similar experience to Violet. They told me I was auditioning for an army sniper named Finn, so maybe that was a little closer to my actual character than yours was. But then I just showed up on the day I was supposed to try on wardrobe, and everybody started calling me Deadshot, and I was like, nah, I don't know what you're talking about. You're the wrong person. I'm playing Finn. And they showed me all the gear, and I still thought they were messing with me. I thought it was like a joke, because they busted out the comic books, and I was like, I know this guy. That's seriously who I'm playing? So I didn't really dig in and read too much of the comic books after that. I just went by his origin story and then what they gave me in the scripts, because they told me they were going for something a little darker and a little grittier. And just built it from there. But, you know, I kind of felt like the work I'd been doing with comedy stuff really helped out to sort of humanize character, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. And even talking about how to become an actor, like your question, like I had a weird kind of route to it, because I was doing music my whole life, and I just took the same kind of approach I always had with my band of just get out there and do it. So me and my younger brother started making stuff and just bought gear. Like, you don't really have an excuse now to not kind of get in the game. You can just make your own things. You can, like, at a certain point, yeah, you got to go and figure out how to have these tools to go deep into these scenes, but, you know, just do it. If you love it, do it, and do it as much as you can. And it's like any job, just keep working and something will happen at some point, you know what I mean? But as far as the other Deadshot, I was really rooting for that movie to do well, to be something special. You know, it is what it is. I'll leave it at that.
What attracts you to a project, and what makes you say, yes, I want to do that film or that TV show?
The easier question would be, what makes you want to say no? Yeah, there's a little bit. I've run into a lot of bad scripts in this past year. Maybe I've got a bit of a bad attitude right now about it, but I actually stopped auditioning for stuff about 6 months ago because I got sick of reading terrible scripts. So I got my stuff together and wrote and am producing a movie right now that I'm filming on the East Coast of Canada. And so that's kind of a different challenge for me, and it was the hardest thing I ever did, but it's going well and I'm enjoying it a lot. So yeah, I mean, if you're offered a character, I guess there's two ways. It's either you relate to it and it's something familiar to you, or something so far away from you that you're like, I want to see if I can do that, and you're up for the challenge. It's usually one or the other with me. I don't know, it's a couple of all-star moments. First stunt scene I rehearsed with the stunt crew, we ripped the ass out of my jeans. That was pretty hilarious. Hit a cameraman in the neck with a fake baton when I was supposed to throw it at one of the other stunt guys. There's a lot of like bloopers that kind of stand out in my head. Yeah, maybe I have a cruel sense of humor.
You hit that guy with the baton on purpose. Yeah,
I didn't, I promise.